Hi guys, welcome back to the farm in Thailand with Toon and Lee. And today Ally, what are you doing, missus?
Working.
You're working? What are you working?
No idea what you're calling in is. Make the fruit pee-pee.
Make the fruit tree pee-pee. Irrigation. It's a hot day, the trees need watering. But guess what? We're not watering them. The pipe is. We've got the pipe working. This is our very, very first effort of laying irrigation pipe work. And the challenge was doing it as cheap as possible. And it looks like we've nailed it. So let's walk you through our wonderful creation on a shoestring. Anyone can do this, piece of fat. Now, if it was money no object, fellas, we would be using all this blue pipe work, but it's probably four times the cost of what we've come up with. So the pipe itself is this stuff here, and your joins, so your little T-sections, and then at the ends, rather than pay for skinny pipe here that has a bayonet fitting going into here, Toon's come up with an ingenious system of squeezing the end and putting a wire around it, and it's working. So she's just going around and adjusting the ends, so we're getting a nice sort of limited flow on all of them. You can see some of them are coming out a little bit too quickly. Try and find one that's... This one is probably just about right. So if we can have them all set up like that, that'd be brilliant. Now the way we've set it up is sort of like a circuit. So this comes straight from the smirt, this blue pipe here. So when the hose is turned off, and the valve down here is open, it then comes down to a T-section, which goes onto the black pipe work. It comes out here, and then we've teed it off. Now we've done it in a complete circuit, so the water doesn't actually get to the end, it comes all the way back. So you can see it's running all the way around the outside here. And then back to the other end of the pipework in here, and then for the middle row we've got another line tied in all the way to the end. So the thought was, if the water flow was struggling to get all the way around or a little bit too fast, that would help to even it out, and it has seemed to work quite well. This one in the corner's locked off, because we've got another fruit tree planned for here. So I've just been prepping the soil, dug a hole beneath the tyre, putting some duck muck in there and some decent soil, and then we'll put a tree in there, and then Toon will fiddle with the wires and get that going again. We will be doing a short video on why we use these tyres. We're great fans of using them for most fruit trees. And then here, we haven't teed this off because some of the things that we planted aren't in a tyre. So we'll just put a little sprinkler head in here. I'll show you one of those in a minute. They're just a bayonet fitting and they just pop into there, and then you've got an adjustable head. So that will go on there and a couple of other trees. But really, really chuffed. I'll check the prices with Toon and then we'll pop them on here, how much it's all cost. Irrigation day two, guys. We did get everything finished quite handy yesterday, but as you can see next door, they were making a right old racket, collecting up all the sugar cane that they'd burnt off, and then the guys had chopped through it. So it was very, very windy as well. So I thought we'll just bin it for the day and just complete the video today. Right, I'll just walk and talk you through it. I can't remember what I talked about yesterday. We were buzzing though. Really good, nice sense of achievement. So we've turned the smirt pump on from the borehole. We'll close this. And open that. And we should have lift off. Takes a few minutes for it just to balance the flow out around everything. So I've mulched all the trees this morning. Took all this stuff out of the chicken coop. That's a mixture of chicken muck, straw and rice husk. But it's going great. We're so happy with it. It's going to save so much time and effort. Currently we've got this set up to do 27 trees in this area. We have got some more trees in the duck enclosure, but we haven't rigged that up for there. I think there's enough water pressure to do it. It's just that every couple of days we like to clean out the little duck pond there. And of course it's got a lot of soil and duck poo in there, so they all go into the tyres that you can see where the trees are in there. So I still want to be doing that. So we're probably not going to expand on it there. Depends, we might go irrigation crazy and do that. Right, let's just talk you through the price. I've just worked it all out, all in my head, so it could go wrong. First off, the pipe work, I'll just show you over here. It comes in a 200 meter roll. It isn't drip tape. It's quite a thin plastic pipe. Easy to cut, easy to put your attachments on. And then little sprinkler heads as well, which we'll put a few on. Now, we've estimated that we've used about 100 metres. Now, for a 200 metre roll, it's 1,000 bar. So there's your 500 straight away. Told you my maths was improving. The next thing that comes up is your little T-sections here. 5 bar to pop. Got a little bit of a leak there. That just needs to be pushed down a little bit more. Remember I was saying yesterday, we haven't used any sprinkler heads on the end. I mean, that's just doing a brilliant job anyway. And what you can do is just push this up and down if you want to increase the flow. If you want to slow it up, then just bring it up a little bit higher. So just go around every few days and check that you make sure everything's coming out nice and balanced. And you need some corner sections as well. Now these are, I think they're 5 bar each. So those and the T sections, we've used just over 30. And then for the trees that haven't got any tires around them, we've just put these little sprinkler heads in. Now I think these are about 5 bar each, maybe 10, I'm not sure, but all you do is you just push a medium sized nail through the pipework on one side, and then there's a little bayonet fitting on there, and once you've got it in there you just turn it to how you want your flow. But to be quite honest, once you put it in, it just starts weeping anyway, so we're quite happy with that. If you had a higher pressure system, I suppose, then you could turn these into an actual little sprinkler. But for our trees, we just want like a little drip system going on. So we only use 4 of those. So all together, we got about 35 of those. You can see here. I'll tell you what we did notice yesterday. Now, prior to us putting this in, when you go round and put a watering can full on each tree, you did used to get the red ants coming out. When we put these on yesterday and left it running for an hour, bloody hell, you could hardly see the tyres on some of them. So they got a battering from us. So the ant numbers will be reduced a lot, which will help the root system because they excavate. Now we probably aim to have this running just for about an hour each day because it does come out quite fast. Of course in the rain season we won't need to do this at all, but much better. And of course we're only using electric ones, whereas before we were using the smart pump to fill up our water tank next to the kitchen, and then of course when we wanted to fill up the watering cans you'd use the pump in the kitchen as well. So this needs a bit of adjusting because it's just dribbling down there. Some of these need to be made a little bit longer. We'll fine tune it as we go along, it's not a problem. This is running just lovely on this mango tree here. Perfect. Love it. So it should really save us about an hour every couple of days. That one's not coming out. Just coming out there. Let's see if I can get a close-up. It's not coming out at that angle. Just needs to be pushed down just a little bit more. And then that'll be fine. Super duper. The other idea we did have was to have the pipe running in between tires, so it would run here and then do a corner up and across and then down and then onto the next one and then use those little orange heads, but I'm glad we went with it this way. We could have just laid the pipe right across, but the main cause that we lose any chickens or ducks is through broken legs, and the last thing we want is pipe work that's up off the floor. So we thought it's nice and pinned down, and then these things themselves are nice and bendy, so it's bird friendly really. Of course if we haven't put everything in tires we could have just run the pipe straight to them like over the far side and use those little orange head things, but we much prefer planting the trees in these tires. I will do a video on it, but basically it makes it so much easier for watering, for feeding, for weeding. Big fans of it. So total cost, I hear you cry, 650 baht for everything we've talked about so far, and then a couple of little bits here, so a T-section, and then this bit screws in and then it's just like a bayonet fitting in there, well like a tapered fitting to go on there, and a little valve. So honestly guys, less than 700 baht to have an irrigation system set up for 26, 27 fruit trees. But the main advantage is, time-wise, it's just going to help us so much. One viewer said quite a while ago, it's about when you're farming, it's about compromising and prioritising. This was becoming long overdue. Now we've got the first system in, we'll be looking at expanding this. That's for sure. We're looking at about increasing our solar capacity and have everything running off a pump in the main lake. Let's just get everything watered automatically. I think that's I think that's a good idea. Right, I think that's it. Irrigation on a budget. You saw it here. It's not the prettiest setup. We may bury it later on, but at the moment, it's good for leaving it exposed so you can check for any leaks and that sort of thing. When we've had it in a while, then we may consider burying it a bit. Some of you are concerned that Toon's not pulling her weight on the videos these days, and we hardly ever see her. It's not me, because I want to. It's Toon being lazy, isn't it, Mrs?
Yeah.
We are flat out, guys. Did mention it in the previous video, and I've pinned the top comment. It's just so time sensitive, our life on the farm, so it's not always possible to video when we're doing the work. I'm normally grabbing the camera when Toon's nipping into town to go and get all the animal food and other supplies for the farm. But I've got the big stick out, and I'll make sure that she does a few more videos soon. Right, guys, thanks for watching. Do your job.
Ta-da for now.